to tell you, I suffer from short-term memory loss. Unless I already told you that. Wow, I am so glad you're here, because if I got a story for you... Wait, do I have a story for you? Yes, I do! It's a story about me and my friends, oh, and my family! Are you ready? Woohoo, let's go! One sec. Maybe you know this. What's that big thing with the wiggly parts? Of course! Duh. Also, what's the floppy doodad that kinda looks like it's got an attitude? Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right! It all started one morning when I was on my way to meet Mr. Ray in his class.
Watch where you're going.
Wow! Then I almost bumped right into a huge unicorn. Phew, that was a close one. I was almost there when I saw Nemo playing with somebody new, a friendly snowman. And then I found Mr. Ray, just in time for class. I was around because Mr. Ray needed help. All his students had disappeared.
What? When did this happen?
Oh, hi, Marlin. This is Marlin. He's my friend. And he looks like, well, I mean, you can see him right here.
Dory, when did the whole class disappear?
Well, listen, I'm telling you. And you. Oh, hang on. What's that cuddly thing? You know, the one with all the pokey bits? right! Oh, and what do you call that noisy thingamajobber? I'm thinking it's a little squishy. Great! Those will come up soon. Okay, here we go. Anyway, since I was the teacher's assistant that day, I told Mr. Ray I'd find all six of his missing students.
Oh, Dory, come on now.
Yes, that's exactly what I said. Come on now, let's find those kids.
Oh.
That's one. I gotcha. Was playing with a bouncy frying pan. Hey there. Woo-ha-ha! Hi, you. Hey.
Oh, watch where you're going.
One more to go.
Oh, watch where you're going.
Woo-ha-ha! That's all of them. I found Nemo last and saved him from a dangerous exploding
Dory!
Alarm clock.
Dory, 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 that did not happen. I would have heard about it.
What's important is that I was a great teacher's assistant, right?
Right, but you said...
Right! Yeah! So that day was the day of the great stingray migration. Mr. Ray took the whole class to the edge of the reef to see it. Field trip! Quick question. What's the thing with the lumps? It makes that noise, you know. Of course! Duh. Also, what do you call the thingamajig? You know, it's round. It kind of tickles. Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right! I love field trips, but I knew I had to keep up with Mr. Ray or I'd forget where I was going.
Oh! Migration, migration, let's learn about migration. It's nature's inspiration to move around the sea.
I had to stop for a moment when I heard the beat of this hypnotic fire truck. Ha! finally got to the edge of the reef, and wow, the stingray migration was incredible! Until I got hit by a speeding UFO.
Are you sure it wasn't a stingray that hit you?
Nope. But whatever happened, it actually turned out to be a good thing.
What? In what way was that possibly a good thing?
Because it helped me remember my family! Yeah! Something. My family was at the gem of the Baltic. No. The stone of the
Jewel of Morro Bay, California.
Yes. Then Crush took Marlin, Nemo, and me on a really fast current. Whee! All the way there. One sec. Maybe you know this. What's that thing? It's bright and shiny, and you always wish there was about 100 of them. Right! Oh, and there's a dilly bob, and it makes this noise that, whoa, it's always way louder than you'd expect. Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right. I remembered this place from when I was a kid. Someone here had to know my parents. I figured if I could find 6 crabs, at least one of them would know where my family was. That's one. Hi, you. Was a really good hider, but I found him under this cute little jack-o'-lantern. Boy, was he hard to find. Probably because he made a home out of a really fashionable traffic cone. The next thing I knew, we woke up... I want to say it was someone named Gary.
It was a giant squid.
Oh, yes, a giant squid! named Gary.
No, no Gary. There was no time for naming.
Oh, right, because Gary was chasing us. Yeah! Remember much, but I definitely remember we had to get away from Gary. Wait, I forget. What do you call that fuzzy thing that makes your eyes go all googly? Right! Oh, and what's that thingamabob? It's totally adorable, but kind of itchy. Wow, good thing you're here. Both of those will be important in a moment. As quickly as we could, we split up and swam. Currents move fast, so we try to use those. A huge unicorn. Get me. I zipped by a passing trophy. Then another, and another. A whole herd of them! Thankfully, they stopped Gary right in his tracks.
A whole herd of them? Dory, no! That's ridiculous. See, there were these shipping containers.
A whole herd of shipping containers? Now who's being ridiculous?
Oh.
Boy, was I happy that squid was gone. But Nemo was really scared after the chase, and I just felt, well, I wanted to find help. Oh, hang on. What's that shiny thing? You never expect it to be there, and then, whoa! There it is. Really? Okay. One more thing. What's the whirly-whiz that spins around and gets you all confused? How could I forget? Just make sure you don't forget about him, okay? Anyway, I decided to look for help in the kelp forest, but I had to find my way through. How it happened. I'm gonna try this again. Usually, I love a bouncy disco ball. But getting through a dozen of them, man, that was tricky.
You know this story. The Jewel of?
The Jewel of Morro Bay, California. We were there! Yeah! So, okay, the downside was I got caught by people from the Marine Life Institute. They put me in quarantine. But hey, big upside, I was closer to finding my parents! Oh, hang on. What's that thing? It's never the first thing you think of. It's, you know, the other thing. Right! Oh, and I'm thinking of a, well, it's kind of heavy, but, you know, still floaty. Great! Those will come up soon. Okay, here we go. Now, I just had to get out of quarantine. And since I was stuck in a tank, I had to look above water for help. Sure ran into that. Into a catchy barbell. You know what that means? Dance break! One final boost from a super helpful jack-o'-lantern.
There you are!
Name's Hank.
how I met Hank. He's a septopus.
Dory, that's not exactly how you told it to me before.
Really? Well, close enough. Hank's great. He helped me get around the Institute, but we took a wrong turn and got thrown into a kiddie touch pool. Wait, I forget. What's the thing with the lumps? It makes that noise, you know. Right! Oh, and what's that cuddly thing? You know, the one with all the pokey bits. How could I forget? Just make sure you don't forget about them, okay? Anyway, I was definitely not a fan of getting poked, but for Hank, the kiddie pool was a nightmare. I had to get us both out of there.
Dory, what are you doing?
I sure ran into that. Hank tried to hide behind a safe-looking bowl of spaghetti. But that didn't turn out so well.
Wow!
So busy dodging hands that we didn't notice the falling bouncy ball. Oops!
Stop it! Sorry.
But it all worked out. Hank's ink made the kids run away and we escaped. After the ink incident, we found out all the blue tanks, including my parents, were in quarantine.
What about the open ocean exhibit, Dory? You left that out.
Oh, okay. Well, the open ocean exhibit is a very nice place to visit. Highly recommended. hang on. What's that thing? It's bright and shiny, and you always wish there was about 100 of them. Of course! Duh. Also, what's the floppy doodad that kind of looks like it's got an attitude? Great! Those will come up soon. Okay, here we go. The only way to quarantine was through this maze of pipes, and I'm not great at mazes. But my friends Destiny and Bailey helped me find the way! If I got lost in the pipes, I could yell to Bailey and he'd help me. Circles, because I'm pretty sure I already passed that rattlesnake. But then I saw Marlin and Nemo.
Dory!
You're okay!
Yeah! Let me tell you, quarantine was one busy place, and the tank of blue tangs was way at the end. Quick question. I'm thinking of it's kind of heavy, but, you know, still floaty. Right! Oh, and what do you call that noisy thingamajobber? I'm thinking it's a little squishy. Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right. I had to get to the end and find my parents.
Woo-hoo! Hi!
Why am I in the air? In this one tank, I got an extra bounce from a springy giraffe. Look, I'm flying! Wow! Wait, that's not right. Guess I got a little carried away there. Hey! Ha! Look, I'm flying! And then I made it! I was in a tank with a familiar-looking rubber ducky. Well, I mean, not just one, but a whole school of them.
Dory, you just said the tank was full of blue tangs!
Well, sure, them too. The point is, my parents had to be there somewhere. Yeah! Except, it turns out my parents weren't in the tank. They were, well, they were gone.
It's okay, Dory. Now remember, we were there. Until Nemo and I got put on a truck going to Cleveland.
Right. Cleveland. And I... I went down a drain! Oh, hang on. There's a dealy bob, and it makes this noise that, whoa, it's always way louder than you'd expect. Really? Okay. One more thing. What's that thing? It's never the first thing you think of. It's, you know, the other thing. Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right. I was flying through the pipe straight out to the ocean. Jack-in-the-box. Then I hit another, and another. Boy, really clobbered that one. Sorry, my bad. Oh, wait, that's not right. Guess I got a little carried away there. And that's the end. No, I'm kidding. Don't worry, let me go back a bit. Hosted by a nice birthday cake. Happens all the time.
Dory, there is just no way you found a party in those pipes.
Well, I didn't find it on purpose, that's for sure. And then, pah, the pipe spit me onto the ocean. Ah. So there I was, in the ocean, again, lost, again. I could see lots of kelp, but not much else. Quick question. What's that big thing with the wiggly parts? That's the one! And while we're at it, I'm thinking of a doodad. It's smallish and smells like, happiness? Yeah! Keep an eye out for both of those, okay? Now, where was I? Oh, right! I had to find something. I don't know what, just something familiar. Oh!
Try to remember.
A shy fire truck. But I guess it had someplace else to be. Something. It was stuck to a mushy soccer ball. It was a purple shell. And I remembered that purple shells were my mom's favorite. So I looked for more purple shells. And there was a trail of them. And then, Mom! Dad!
Dory!
I found my parents! Turns out, my parents escaped to the ocean to look for me. And they've been leaving shell trails for me to find ever since. All that time, they'd waited for me because they knew I'd find them one day. And I did. I did. I remembered! Yeah! So everything was great because I'd found my parents, but then everything was not great because Nemo and Marlin and Hank were on a truck headed for Cleveland. One sec. Maybe you know this. What do you call the thingamajig? You know, it's round, it kind of tickles. Of course! Duh. Also, what's that thingamabob? It's totally adorable, but kind of itchy. Great! Those will come up soon. Okay, here we go! Bailey, used his echolocation to find the truck, but we didn't know how to stop it. Then, got an idea. We just needed to catch up to the truck first.
Oh, yes, my beautiful gift. Found it!
Suddenly, Bailey spotted something up ahead. It was an enormous bouncy ball.
Holy Neptune!
We barely missed it! And they agreed to help. Those cute little guys got up to the bridge by bouncing on a passing frying pan. How would that help? Because it was time for my idea. A cuddle party! It was so adorable, the truck had to stop. And we got our friends to safety!
Holy crap.